स्टूडेंट्स इन दिस वीडियो वी विल लर्न अबाउट क्वेश्चंस व्हाट अ क्वेश्चन इज एवरी क्वेश्चन हैज एन आंसर हियर वी विल टॉक अबाउट क्वेश्चन इन डिटेल्स सो लेट्स स्टार्ट देयर आर बेसिकली थ्री मेजर टाइप्स ऑफ क्वेश्चन फर्स्ट इज यस नो क्वेश्चन सेकेंड इज WH क्वेश्चंस थर्ड इज अल्टरनेटिव क्वेश्चंस व्हाट इज अ यस नो क्वेश्चंस यस नो क्वेश्चंस is a question the reply to which is either a yes or no or in other words the reply to this question is a yes or no for example have you had lunch so you will say yes or no if you had your lunch you will say yes if you had your lunch if you didn't have your lunch you will say no now second WH questions These questions are formed using question words like what, why, when, who, where, and how. Each word here you can find is starting with WH. Now, the reply to this question is not a simple yes or no, but you have to give a positive range of response. That means when a question is asked with WH questions, you cannot give your answer by simply saying yes or no. But you have to give a complete range of answer. For example, where is Nitya's house? You will say it's in Lal Bagh. You cannot say either yes or no. But you have to give here a positive range of response. Now, alternative questions. The reply to alternative question is one of the option given by the question itself. That means you have to give the answers to alternative question by choosing an option given in the question itself. Your answer should be among the options given in the question itself. Let's see with the help of example. Would you like to watch TV or chat online? Here it is asked whether you like to watch TV or chat online. So your answer should be among the two options asked in the question. So if you like to watch TV, you'll say I would like to watch TV. But if you want to chat online, you will say I would like to chat online. Your answer should be among the two question itself. Okay, now let's study about yes no questions in detail. Basically, yes or no questions are formed by placing the verb before the subject. Yes no questions are formed with the help of placing the verb before the subject. For example, a simple statement is given, your hands are wet. When we form a yes no question, from this statement we will ask like are your hands wet so what you will say if your hands are wet you will say yes and if your hands are not wet you will say no so yes or no now when there is a helping verb in the statement its question form will have this structure that means any statement which is having a helping verb how we will form a question will form a question from the below structure and the structure will be like helping verb plus subject plus main verb plus other parts of the predicate what will be the structure of the question helping verb plus subject plus main verb plus other parts of the predicate that means helping verb will come first then will come subject then it will come main verb then other parts of the predicate let's see the below chart there are four columns here first column is for helping verb second is for subject third is for main verb and fourth is for other parts of the predicate so here we are going to form a structure of the question so under helping verb you can find can under subject you can find Alicia under main verb it is written sing and under other parts of the predicate it is written well so when we'll join it will form a question like can Alicia sing well this is the structure of a question when there is a helping verb in the statement So now when there is no helping verb in the statement, the structure for the question will be like, in the simple present tense it will be different, and for simple past tense it will be different. We will need to supply do, does or did as shown in the table below. I'll help you to explain this with the help of an example. Here in the chart you can see, or in the table you can see, it is written singular subject and it is written plural subject. Singular means if we talk about a single person, how we will form the structure of the question, and if we will talk about the plural subject, how we will form the structure of the question. Now first we will deal about present tense statement. So when we will form a present tense statement question, or related to statement of present tense statement, will form like does plus subject plus base form of the verb plus other parts of the predicate. What will be the structure? Does plus subject plus base form of the verb plus other parts of the predicate. So for example, our statement is Suraj makes tea. So what will be the structure of the question? Does Suraj make tea? Does plus subject plus base form of the verb plus other parts of the predicate. You can see here, does Suraj make tea? So does plus Suraj is a subject, plus make is a verb, plus tea is a other parts of the predicate. This was about singular subject. But when we will talk about plural subject, we will include do plus subject plus base form of the verb plus other parts of the predicate. Plural means more than two or two. So here when we will see a simple statement, simple present tense statement in for plural subject, it will be like Suraj and Sandhya make tea. Here it is two persons, so they are plural. How we will form the question? Do sir Suraj and Sandhya make tea? This was the form of the question. Plus subject plus base form of the verb plus other parts of the predicate. Now for example, a simple statement is Suraj made tea. This is a simple past statement. So how we'll form the structure for this statement, or the form of the question structure for this statement? Did plus subject plus base form of the verb plus other parts of the predicate. So it will be like, did Suraj make tea? Did plus Suraj is a subject, plus make is a verb, plus tea is the other parts of the predicate. This was for singular subject. But when we will talk about plural subject, there will be no change in the form of the structure. Now coming to WH questions. WH questions are formed with the help of the question words like the what, which, when, where, how, why, who, whose. Here each question word starts with WH. If you notice, what starts for WH, which start for WH, when start for WH, where start for WH. Each of the question words contains WH questions. Now, these questions have large number of answers. That means each question will have different patterns of answer. But unlike yes or no questions, which have only two possible answers, yes or no. That means when we ask yes or no question, there will be only two possible answers. That will be either yes or no. But when we ask WH question, there you can find a variety of answers. For example, if you ask yes no question, is tomorrow your birthday? So you will say either yes or no. If tomorrow is your birthday, you will say yes. And if you don't have your birthday, you will say no. But for WH question like, what day is your birthday? You will tell it in detail that my birthday is on 1st April 23rd January. Or whenever is your birthday. So you have to give your full detail. You cannot say yes or no. Now look at the table given below. You can find three columns here. That is question words used to ask about an example. That means, what type of question word is used to ask about what? And I'll explain you with an example. First is what? Why is what used? What is used to ask about thing? or ideas and not people. That means what is asked only for things or ideas, not people. For example, what is the color of turmeric? Second comes which. Which is used to ask about either things, ideas or people. For example, which car is your mother's? Third is who. Who is used to ask about people? For example, who was the man on the terrace? Next come whom. Whom is also used to ask about people. For example, whom did Chiku meet in the jungle? Whose is also used to ask about people. For example, whose is the kerchief with the red border? When is used for time. For example, when will the hunters come back? It is asking here about time. Where is used to ask about place. For example, where are my headphones? How is used to ask about manner in which something happened. Like for example, how did the prisoner escape? You are asking for something, how it has happened. Why? Why is used to ask for the reason of something. Why did the police officer run away? You are asking here for an reason. So here we have done with the WH questions. Now comes alternative questions. Alternative questions gives a choice between the option contained in the question themselves. That means your answer should be among the options given in the question itself. The options are connected by or. For example, are you a policeman or a soldier? So you cannot give a different answer. You have to choose among these two options given in the question itself. So if you are a policeman, you will say I am a policeman. And if you are a soldier, you will say I am a soldier. So your answer should be among the two options itself. I hope you have understood the chapter. Thank you.